Welcome to this new episode of No U-Turn. Hope you enjoy. Welcome, everybody. In today's episode, I would like to speak about the rise of Geert Wilders. Before I'm going to talk about him, however, I would want to explain a little bit about the political landscape and some happenings in the last decades. In the Netherlands, we have a very fractured political system. For the next elections, for example, there are 28 parties to choose from. The system results in a slow-moving and very compromising politics. Extremes on both sides most of the time will be pulled towards the center, since the government will have to be made up of several smaller factions. With that said, let's talk about the sentiment that Geert Wilders is using to grow. After the Second World War, there was a huge boom in the economy. In the late 50s and 60s, there was a shortage of low-skilled workers. This meant that companies started to try and get foreign workers to work on those jobs. In the early 60s, this changed to a governmental program, first from Southern Europe and later from Turkey and Morocco. The people coming from these countries were given a green card and a work permit. The jobs, however, were only temporary. The prevailing thought at this moment was that those people would go back to country of origin after the period of work would cease. This is the reason why this group of people are called guest workers. Over the years, however, it became clear that this was not the case and these groups were largely permanently settled in this country. On the turn of the century, the prevailing discourse was changing, however. Before this, it was mostly talk about multiculturalism, and after this it started to shift towards a forced cultural integration over ethnic lines, and it became more important to talk clearly about problems. With the attack on the World Trade Center, however, this conversation also started to include Islam as a religion. And as a result, a controversial figure stood up as a new political leader, Pim Fortuyn. He started attacking cultural relativism and political correctness. During his rise, however, almost the complete political system and the press started attacking him as a right-wing extremist. This, however, did not slow down his rise. This was until he was shot and killed on the 2nd of May of 2002 by a left-wing figure. After this incident, it was very apparent that a divide has formed between the left and the right. 2 years after the murder of Pim Fortuyn, another controversial figure, Theo van Gogh, published together with Ayaan Hirsi Ali a short film on television named Submission. This was a 10-minute during film that was based around domestic violence in Islam and the treatment of women in this culture. 3 months after this film, Theo van Gogh was murdered by an Islamic extremist. This sent another shockwave through society. This shockwave started the rise of Geert Wilders, since he was the one who took a hardline stance on immigration from Islamic countries. Since then, he has used every incident as an opportunity to profile himself. The next big thing to happen was the 2015 migrant crisis. This was the perfect crisis for Geert, since it was from an Islamic country, as well as that the amount of migrants created very big problems in the amount of resources that was available for the housing of migrants, etc. A second benefit for him is the fact that Germany took a stance of unlimited migrants. And with the Schengen Agreement, this would mean that every migrant who would get a green card from Germany be able to cross boundaries. And this makes his second spearhead, leaving Europe, a very appealing option. Even though, for the coming elections, the polls say that he will be the largest party, there are still some major hurdles for him to overcome. His plan to de-Islamize the Netherlands can't be executed under current law. our constitution does prohibit discrimination on the basis of religion. So his plan to completely stop immigration from Islamic countries, closure of all mosques and Islamic schools, and his total ban of the Quran is a pipe dream. The second problem he is facing is a so-called strategic vote. Since we have so many small parties to choose from, a lot of people don't vote for a fixed party, but choose to vote based on what is happening during the election cycle. Since a while now, a lot of people are starting to say that they probably, instead of voting for the left side of the spectrum, they would rather vote for a political party that's more on the right side of the spectrum, but still is for them acceptable. So we will just have to wait and see and what will happen on the 15th of March. I put my sources in the description box and questions you can leave in the comments. Also, please consider to leave a like and subscribe.